Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man Tales, No Tales. Now, this is the fifth installment in the Pirates of the Caribbean franchise. Who would have thought that would have made five movies out of a Disneyland ride? Come in your crib with a boat, shake and bait, Ricky Bobby. Shake and bait, Ricky Bobby. Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man Tales, No Tales. It's about another curse, another story where they have to break a curse because this boy is trying to save his dad who's been cursed, and he needs Jack Sparrow because it's always Jack Sparrow's involved in every single curse. He's like the most known person in the entire world. The world is huge. They don't even have access to no communication. They're pirates. They live in the sea and everybody knows Jack Sparrow. The entire British Navy, the Spanish Navy. So the story, Jack Sparrow is involved with Captain Zalazar because he also is trying to break his own curse because of Jack Sparrow. Now this other kid, he needs Jack Sparrow to break this other curse. So it's a bunch of curses that they're just trying to break, and that's basically the entire movie. Now I'm gonna get into the spoiler section because I really want to talk about this movie. First of all, this is the worst movie in the entire franchise in my opinion. Question for today is, rank the five Pirates of the Caribbean movies in the order that you guys think are the best five movies. So I will be doing mine at the end of the video, so please stick around. Pirates of the Caribbean 5 is so annoying because it ruined Jack Sparrow. You're talking about, you ruined the only thing that we watch Pirates of the Caribbean movies for is because Jack Sparrow is going to do some amazing acting. It's his role. Like, he was born to play this role. And they ruined it. Because in the other movies, we know that Jack Sparrow, he's always doing these ridiculous stunts and telling jokes and being a goofball. But at the end of the movie or throughout the scenes, he ends up doing badass shit. But in this movie, Jack Sparrow is just a joke throughout the entire movie. And I know that his character is supposed to be a joke, but this one, he doesn't do anything cool. In this movie, everything is so predictable. And that's what I hated about this movie, because the other movies, like, you didn't know what was going to happen. It was just crazy, getting out of trouble. It was pretty cool. This one is just so generic. There's nothing exciting about this movie. This movie drags, and it's bad. The first, like, 50 minutes, you're introducing, like, these little scenarios and the characters. And first off, you have Nick Turner, which is the son of Will Turner and Elizabeth, which it didn't feel right. I didn't feel for this character. This character just was kind of eh. Like, I just didn't care. I wasn't rooting for him. Like, I like Will, but I didn't really care if he saved Will. Like, because, like, apparently Will Turner's been stuck in the Flying Dutchman for, like, 15 years or something. So I didn't care about this character at all. And he was, like, the main focus of this movie, along with the girl who happened to be the daughter of Barbossa. Like, that was just so stupid, in my opinion. Like, first of all, you can't even just focus on Will Turner's son. You have to focus on freaking Barbossa's daughter. Like, it made no sense to me. And they stole the focus from Jack Sparrow, which is the drive of this movie. So everything just was so annoying. The dialogue was stupid. I understand it was cool. Oh, this girl's smart. She's a witch. And then they continued it. Like, every character, they're just like, dude, get over it. We saw that she was a witch in the first, like, act of this movie. You could tell that this girl was only in the movie because they needed a female leading role, and I just didn't care about her either. Like, first you give me Nick Turner, or I think that was his name, and then you give me her to root for, and you still want me to root for Jack Sparrow, and then you add so many layers, and you have the Captain Zalazar. Like, Captain Zalazar was actually a little cool, and I like his backstory. Like, this movie would have been a lot more interesting if they've made this movie about his backstory. Like, that's a movie I would have wanted to see, like, Salazar just killing all the pirates, and then at the end Jack Sparrow kind of, like, tricks him and sends him to this, like, underworld, whatever. That would have been a much better movie. If they would have made that movie and then followed it maybe with this movie, it would have made a lot more sense. But still, the ending of this movie was actually pretty cool. If you've seen the movie, Elizabeth Swann and Will Turner, you finally get to see them back in the Pirates of the Caribbean movie, which was really, it was a really touching moment. I really enjoyed the ending. And the last 20 minutes, they were action-packed, even though there was, like, some ridiculous stuff going on, like, on the anchor. And, like, Barbossa didn't need to kill Salazar and sacrifice himself. Like, they could have just killed him when they went up. It was just kind of a necessary sacrifice. Like, I didn't even feel it. Nobody in the theater was like, oh no, Barbossa's dying for his daughter. It was just more like, okay, I guess Salazar and Barbossa are dead. Like, it was just dumb. And then some of the side characters, because a lot of the side characters in the other Pirates of the Caribbean movie, they're comedy relief guys and they're cool, but these guys, like, they had, like, new characters that it just didn't work. Like, it just seemed a little bit too forced. You know what was happening throughout the entire movie. Like, there was no surprise. It was so sad because everyone in the theater, we were watching this and they would do, like, these jokes and the theater was silent. Like, maybe one or two people laughed, but everyone was like, okay, that was kind of pointless. And most of this movie just feels like that. There were some good moments of Jack Sparrow. Don't get me wrong, there's some good action sequences, some good sword battles, and the classic jumping from ship to ship, all the stuff they always do. But still, like, this movie was just so disappointing. I actually enjoyed the last movie, so this one's disappointing because the last movie, you brought in mermaids, you brought more sea mythology. It was kind of like refreshing. Blackbeard and even Salma Hayek with Jack Sparrow, they had good chemistry in that movie. So the storyline, it was a little bit crazy, but it was actually a fun movie to watch.
Heart is pierced by Cupid, I disdain all glittering gold. There is nothing can console me but my jolly sailor boy.
And the entire scene with the freaking mermaids was amazing. Everybody, like, that was kind of cool. This one, it has no cool moments like that until the last 20 minutes of the movie. It's disappointing that I'm saying that Pirates 5 is the worst movie of 2017, because I love Pirates of the Caribbean. I love Jack Sparrow, and I can't believe they ruined the character. I can't believe they ruined everything. And even the score for this movie just seemed like everything you've ever seen before. Like I said, in the last movie, you at least had like some new music when the freaking mermaids and all this stuff. This one, it was literally all the songs from Pirates of the Caribbean when Jack Sparrow is doing this, and it just got kind of old. And I love Hans Zimmer because, I mean, I even watched him at Coachella. He was my favorite performance from Coachella, and it was just disappointing. Like, there was nothing exciting about this movie. Overall, this movie ruined Jack Sparrow for me. It ruined all the characters and everything I love about Pirates of the Caribbean. They had score. They don't bring anything new to the table. And it does, visually, it looks pretty good because it's a Disney movie with a high budget. But the only thing that saves this movie for me is the ending with Will Turner and Elizabeth Swann. So I'm going to give this movie a grade of a D. My top five, I have Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl, number one. Number two, I have Pirates of the Caribbean 4, On Stranger Tides, because it kind of refreshed the franchise. Who is Desmond's Chest? It's at World's End. And the fifth one is this fifth one, which was just so disappointing. Dead Man Tells No Tales. So let me know, what do you guys rank your five Pirates of the Caribbean movies? And if you like this movie, please let me know in the comment section. I would love to hear why you like this movie, or if you think this movie was actually pretty good. Please let me know in the comment section. I love to have conversations about movies. So that's it for today, guys. My name's Angel. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.